अगर हेल्थ प्रोफेशनल्स, डॉक्टर्स, नर्सेज, अदर हेल्थ वर्कर्स, द सिक्योरिटी एंड द सैनिटेशन वर्कर्स इन्वॉल्व इन द हॉस्पिटल, अवर फ्रंटलाइन वर्कर्स, अवर कोविड वॉरियर्स एंड ऑफकोर्स आई हैव ऑलवेज सेड दैट अवर जर्नलिस्ट फ्रेंड्स दे हैव ऑल्सो बीन द फ्रंटलाइन कोविड वॉरियर्स and all through 2020 you have been reporting from ground zero, taking all the risks yourself and sharing all relevant and good information to the people of India. And all through 2020 you have been reporting from ground zero, taking all the risks yourself and sharing all relevant and good information with the people of India. So first of all, my greetings to all of you in particular and to the people of Tamil Nadu. And it's not my greeting, it is the greeting of my beloved Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji, who has always been inspiring us all through 2020. He has guided, he has led from the front, he has been proactive and he has monitored everything very meticulously. So I convey the good wishes of my Prime Minister to the people of Tamil Nadu today. Today is 8th January and I recall that exactly 1 year back, when on 6th of January the World Health Organization had informed the whole world about the cases of corona which have appeared in China of experts in the health ministry. So it is full 1 year now since we had responded to the news of COVID outbreak in the whole world. 2020 has been an year where virtually everyone rose to the occasion. The central government under the leadership of Prime Minister Narendra Modi, it was a whole of government approach, it was a whole of society approach. Every state government, all the health ministers, all the non-government organizations, social organizations, and of course the scientists, apart from the medical professionals, they have shown exemplary performance, exemplary dedication and commitment. And in 2020 we could see that on most of the fronts, on almost every front, with the help of medical professionals and scientists, we could do extremely well. And the performance of 2020 on the COVID front for the whole of the world, and then you can compare it with India, highest recovery rate, lowest fatality rate. Out of something like 1 crore 4 lakh patients who got affected with COVID, more than 1 crore, almost all of them literally have recovered and gone back home. And in the last one year you have seen, we started our journey with one testing lab. Today when I talk to you, after exactly one year, we already have 2,300 laboratories in the whole country. We are exporting PPE kits. We have the capability now to be able to export N95 masks, drugs, ventilators, everything that people used to talk towards the beginning of the pandemic in India as so-called shortages which we were importing, including of course the testing kits, which we are producing almost a million testing kits a day. Now everything we have been able to take care of in India itself, and this has happened because of the inspiration given by the Prime Minister for the development of an Atmanirbhar Bharat by the countrymen. Today I am so happy and delighted to be here in Tamil Nadu. You know that in the shortest possible time, India has also done extremely well on the front of the development of vaccine. And right now, two of our vaccines have been given emergency use authorization. And we are in the process of ensuring that in the next few days or so, in the near future, we should be able to give these vaccines to our countrymen, starting with, of course, prioritizing those who are most at risk, our health professionals, healthcare workers in the public and private sector, followed by frontline workers, our police, our army people, our paramilitary people, our sanitation and our municipal corporation, and all those frontline workers who helped us in containment zones and other places. And then of course, in the next stage, we'll be taking up the people above 50 years of age, and then of course less than 50 with comorbidities. You are already aware of the scheme of things that have been discussed with all of you earlier also, to ensure that in a country as vast as India, with a population of 1.35 billion people, everything is done smoothly, meticulously, without any glitches. We started preparations for the impending vaccination drive against COVID almost 4 to 5 months back, when the Prime Minister had constituted an expert group, national expert group for vaccine administration. Our people in the Health Ministry, along with others and in consultation with the stakeholders in the states, we have been working day and night to formulate guidelines, to work out the minutest possible details, and also to ensure that every detail is conveyed to the people at the grassroots level, starting from the national level to the grassroots level. Lakhs of healthcare workers have been trained adequately. The process continues, and we are using the use of, we are having technology, electronic intelligence network. We earlier used to have a even platform, which we have converted into a COVID platform now. Even was electronic vaccine intelligence network, and now we have this COVID. Earlier, during the routine immunization program, We were only tracking the vaccine along with its place and the temperature on which it is being stored or maintained. But now it is also tracking, the new COVID platform is tracking the details of the potential beneficiary, the place where he is likely to get the vaccination, and then pre-vaccination and post-vaccination, including giving him an electronic certificate, following up with him for the second dose through detailed text messages, reminders. So it's a very detailed exercise, and it's almost a 150-page document that we have shared with the states for all the details to be shared with the people who are going to make it successful. The present exercise that's happening today is a national dry run. You can call it a sort of a mock exercise for ensuring that we are thoroughly prepared about it. And you are all aware by now, we had started with 4 states in the beginning and a few districts towards the fag end of December 2020, and then taking some inputs from that, we had put some amendments in our guidelines also. Then on second also we did this dry run in almost 125 districts of the whole country, and then following upon that, today it is happening all over the country except 3 states which have done it earlier. I was privileged to have visited and seen from close quarters the nitty-gritty of this in the capital of India on 2nd of January. And today I chose to be in the southernmost part of India, in one of the southern states, Tamil Nadu. And I can only say with conviction, and I would like to place on record my sincere most appreciation for the good work that has been done by Tamil Nadu. Our health minister, with the blessings of the chief minister, and with dynamic officers like the present health secretary and all his colleagues here, the government sector as well as in the private sector. And I know that a couple of months back, this Chennai was itself in a lot of trouble. All through we were worried about many states. Of course, Tamil Nadu was also one of them. But the way things were done in such a good manner in Tamil Nadu, and I was particularly impressed by the fact that 100% tests in Tamil Nadu were done by RT-PCR. And meticulous planning about testing, tracing, management, treatment, and while being treated in the hospital, so many good things have been happening which I had heard, but today I was fortunate to have a glimpse of many of those things. And that's why I had asked the minister. He said now we are having less than 1,000 cases, sometimes 700, 800, and yesterday probably it was something like 800. So they have to keep up the good work. The country has been, you can say, left with 2 vaccines available right now, and we will make sure that in the near future we start the vaccination drive for the priority groups and do it with meticulous precision at even the remotest sites for vaccination in the country. I will also use this occasion to highlight and underline one fact, which is another program in almost 10 days from now, about which I had spoken to all the health ministers in the country yesterday through the video conference. January 2021, and it was January 2011, exactly 10 years back, we had seen the last case of polio in this country, somewhere in near Howrah in West Bengal. We eradicated polio and was certified by the World Health Organization in 2014. Today, in spite of the fact that virtually all the countries in the world have eradicated polio, but two of our neighboring countries still have cases of poliomyelitis, the P1 strain, and the number is significant. Because of the presence of the P1 polio virus in two neighboring countries, our population always remains at risk. So the National Expert Group on Immunization, in consultation with the international health authorities, we have decided that on 17th of January, we are going to have our National Immunization Days for polio, which will run for about 2-3 days. The first day will be dedicated to every mother taking a child to the polio kendra for vaccination, followed by another 2-3 days when we go back and search for those left out children in the community. This is very, very essential to ensure that we are able to maintain the overall immunity level of our country, particularly pertaining to poliomyelitis. So my appeal today, polio vaccine on that day. And I am sure that not only the country, but of course Tamil Nadu, you have a very robust health system. In the country also, we have shown time and again our competence through the universal immunization program, through the measles and rubella immunization program, one of the biggest in the whole world that we had undertaken in recent years, by having eradicated diseases like smallpox and polio from a country as fast as India. So we have the capability, we have the experience, we have the vision, and we have the great leadership of a very dynamic Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi ji. I'm sure we are going to perform well on that front also. And regarding the COVID vaccination, which will start in the future, near future time, I would request the non-government organizations, NGOs, more particularly the ones working in the field of health, and of course our young workers involved with organizations like NCC, NSS, etc., to help in the smooth conduct of the COVID vaccination program and the mobilization of the potential beneficiaries in the best possible manner. So I am sure all this is going to happen very smoothly all across the country. Once again, I would like to thank Tamil Nadu for making arrangements here for me to be able to see some of the proposed vaccination sites for COVID. This is the first site that I have visited, and I find that the arrangements have been made as per the guidelines given by the Government of India. And I would request that the minister should, in the coming few days, personally ensure that everything is carefully, most diligently monitored. Once again, I convey the good wishes of my Prime Minister for all the people of Tamil Nadu. Thank you. Thank you, my COVID warriors, my dear journalist friends from Chennai.